victims of human rights violations in the Philippines continue to face challenges in seeking justice amid persisting reports of abuses in the country. That's according to a new United Nations report. The Office of the High Commission for Human Rights acknowledged Manila's pledge to work within the mechanisms of the UN, as well as the initial implementation of the UN Joint Program on Human Rights in the country. But the office also noted that access to justice for victims of human rights violations remains very limited. It adds the continued reports of harassment, threats, arrests, attacks, red tagging, and continued drug-related killings by police in the past 2 years raise serious concerns. The OHCHR urges the Marcos administration to take steps in protecting citizens who want to speak out and address human rights challenges. It also recommended the Justice Department expedite its review of the killings under the previous Duterte administration's war on drugs.
The minority bloc of the Philippine Senate says Executive Secretary Vic Rodriguez is not entirely blameless in the sugar importation fiasco. Senators Coco Pimentel and Risa Hontiveros released their own findings on the issue, disputing an earlier Blue Ribbon Committee report that absolved Rodriguez of any blame. The Senate panel had instead recommended the filing of administrative and criminal charges against suspended agriculture official Leocadio Sebastian and former Sugar Regulatory Administration officials Hermenegildo Serafica, Roland Beltran, and Aurelio Valderrama for approving the importation of 300,000 metric tons of sugar into the country without President Marcos's consent. But the minority senators believe they were merely used as scapegoats and that Rodriguez should be the one held accountable for the government's botched importation plan.
Nagkulang siya dahil lumalabas, hindi niya timely at kompletong ini-inform si Presidente sa progress nitong prosesong ito that led to Sugar Order Number 4.
Unfair to make the four personalities scapegoats, fall guys. Yun lang masasabi namin kay ES. Also, look at yourself in the mirror kasi masasakit yung mga sinabi niya eh.
The Senate minority also slammed the Blue Ribbon Committee for supposedly failing to get a good grasp of the issue. They insist there is a sugar crisis in the country that the government has yet to address. They also plan to oppose the recommendation of Blue Ribbon Committee Chairman Francis Tolentino for a lookout order against the former agriculture officials involved in the controversy.
It's an unfair committee report, lalo na dun po sa apat. Kaya sabi namin sa minority report namin, these are human beings with careers, with reputations, and with families. Hindi natin alam ang situation ng family nila, may mga sakit pa yung iba.
Tolentino meanwhile backed off from commenting on the letter, saying he has yet to receive a copy of the minority report.
The former sugar regulatory chief, meanwhile, welcomed the Senate minority report. Hermenegildo Serafica thanked Senators Pimentel and Ontiveros, saying they clearly see the data and evidence he submitted in his defense. He insists he and the other sugar regulatory officials were only doing their duties and had done nothing wrong.
The Philippines' local sugar production this year ordered reserved for domestic consumption. That's the new directive of the Sugar Regulatory Administration. Sugar Order Number 1 covers the current crop year, which will last until the end of August 2023. 1.8 million metric tons of raw sugar are expected to be produced during this period. The order was signed by Philippine President and Agriculture Secretary Ferdinand Marcos Jr., Agriculture Undersecretary Domingo Panganiban, and three SRA officials, including Acting Administrator David Tadeus Alba. The SRA is in charge of classifying locally produced sugar as for U.S. quota for domestic consumption, for reserve, or for the world market.